Well, there's always a plan B.
Hey everybody, my name is Jelle and you're watching to my YouTube channel. Today you will see how I bought a Munk of Tunnel sprayer and I started working on it last November because it really took a lot of time to get this one properly going again. It did work before but did not function 100%. And every single detail on the machine was just worn out and just needed a fix. So this machine is 25 years old. Dad says it does not fit anywhere in our company. So I had to prove him wrong a lot of times. Because it does fit. It barely fits, but it fits. And that's the most important thing. It has to fit. If it doesn't fit, it doesn't make sense to have it. So it's a really old sprayer, especially for being a sprayer. And I came across it on eBay. So I bought it, I brought it home, and I'm gonna see if I like to spray with it or if I don't like to. I know it has a lot of disadvantages, but it also has some really crucial advantages. And that's the reason I wanna give it a try. To see how this machine performs and also to improve the machine. Because it is 25 years old, and in 25 years, a lot of new technology came across. So I'm gonna see if I can update it or not. And I will be finding out if it makes any sense to be driving with this kind of sprayer in the year 2021 and after. So what exactly makes this machine what the machine is? The machine is intended to go over the apple trees instead of going between them. And this tunnel will completely go over the apples. The spraying product will come out of the nozzles and it will be mixed into the trees in the middle. So the tree is standing in the middle of us and we are driving over it. These fans in the back will provide the air support, which is coming out of here. So we got air support behind the nozzles. And we also have an electrical adjustable angle for the air. Another big advantage of this system is a spraying product collection system. So the product that is not going on the tree will not drop on the ground, but it will drop on these parts here. From here on, that will be sucked up again and back into the tank. The machine at this moment is folded in, and that's why this part is up, because if I fold it out, it will go down, just like on this side. The thing is that it should not be down at this side at this moment, but a cylinder is leaking and that's causing it to extend a bit, and that's why this side dropped. So on the front we have the tank, and that one is connected in the hitch, so it's actually hanging partly on the tractor and for a part on the sprayer. The sprayer can fold out into that direction, and that way we get a tunnel over the trees, and we can also extend the tunnel so it can become a lot wider, so it can do really wide trees if you want to do, but we have small trees, so this will probably also be the position that we will be spraying in, and we will just fold it out and that should be all. So in the cab we got a little control box. It's for the fans on and off, spraying on and off. The light, which actually still works. It's not an LED, but it does work. And probably I replace it for an LED. I can also adjust the pressure with this one. So I can raise or lower it. And I can rotate the angle of the air. Besides that, I also got two hydraulic functions for folding the sprayer in and out. And also for shifting it left and right. Now I already did some experimenting and I found out that the boxes below here are leaking badly, and they are 25 years old, and iron together with spraying product and aging makes stuff really worse. As you can see, the wool sprayer is rusted and it's not in the best shape, but that's what you get for a cheap eBay machine. Now, the rust is not that bad that I can go through, so it still makes sense to do anything on this machine, and I will make sure that the components I put on here are still salvageable for a next project, so I don't want to throw
just money in it without knowing anything. I want to make sure that I can get it back if the sprayer for some reason gets a major defect that I cannot repair.
So let's get started by taking the two bottom sides off so we can find out why it's leaking that bad and probably restore them or make new parts so it's not leaking anymore. Every single bolt down here was rusted really hard, so I had to cut them all to get everything loose. So I have to make a new copy of this, and I also want to improve it. At least I want to make it out of stainless steel. So that's what I'm doing at this moment. I got two pieces of stainless steel tube, and I also got stainless steel plates to make a new bucket with. And I want to form the bucket a little bit different to give it a try to get a little bit more flow into the bucket. So now I got to make walls on all the sides. Then this will be the inside of the bucket, and this will be the support, just like the old one has. Because I do want a tube inside for the support of this one. Because if I crash into anything or so, I don't want to break my bucket. This was actually the first time TIG welding for me. So I had to learn everything. And that means that the first welds were not that pretty. But after that it went pretty okay, as long as I could sit on the workbench. So I think it worked out not too bad. I will put water in it and see if it stays dry overnight to find out if I welded it properly. So it did stay dry overnight, and I'm really glad about that, so I could continue the work. So here I'm drilling holes for the flexible arms, because the arms of the bucket have to flex. If they hit a tree, they should flex away. And this is gonna be the pivot point for that arms. And I need to drill big holes for that, because it needs to have decent pins, otherwise it would break apart over time. And I don't want this to break apart over time. As progress goes on, the welding seems to go better and better, and it starts to look really clean now, because I start to learn more and more about how to weld the TIG properly without adding too much or not enough metal to it. You can see in earlier work that it's still kind of rough, and in the later work it's pretty fine. So basically this is what it's gonna look like at the bottom of the tunnel sprayer on both sides. Now I just need to weld it up properly so it's decent and I can actually build it on the sprayer. I made a small mistake here. This is sticking up too high, and if it's folded in, this end could end up in the filter or in the tank, and we don't want that. So we are gonna cut this one and aim it down more, so it won't hurt the tank in any case. What I need now is a skid. So this can run over the ground just like on that side. It has a skid that touches the ground and it will lift the complete thing up if it touches ground. This side also needs it, otherwise this gets a hard beating. And we don't want to beat this up, we want to beat something up that's below it. I'm not gonna make that out of stainless steel because that's gonna be a wearing part and it's easier for me to weld it if it's normal steel than when it's stainless steel. So let's make something. You will not be seeing me spraying with the sprayer in this video, but that will be seen in the next video. I hope to see you next time again on my channel. And don't forget to like, share and subscribe so you get a notification when a new video comes online.